Now, increasing decreasing function, of course, the keyword here you will see is increasing and decreasing. So you will say, they will ask you, so when this is an increasing function, what happened? When this is a decreasing function, what happened? Now, what's the key idea of increasing function? Dy over dx is equal to 0, less than 0, or more than 0? More than 0, correct. Can you write that down? Then for decreasing, of course, it's the other way. Dy dx less than 0. Now, the first point tells you about first, second, third derivative. So there are two ways of writing it. One is the left-hand side. One is the second column and third column. So second derivative means d square y dx square. Or you can put f then stroke. Two apostrophe there. This one means differentiate two times. This one means differentiate three times. Can follow? Okay. Now, next one. This is the one. So if it's increasing function, then the linkage is dy dx more than 0. Okay? Don't have decreasing. Then of course decreasing is the opposite. Just now we have mentioned. Okay? Now, so let me start with an example. So for example, if they say this is increasing function, what happened?
Dy over dx less than
0. Dy over dx
more than 0,
right? So can you see this is your dy dx? Can you underline this and put dy dx? And this is the one because they say what? Increasing function, right? Alright, so you analyze the solution because the first one is dy dx, the second one is because they tell you it's increasing, so you can write it down. So when I have quadratic equation, then how do I do? This is the topic of inequality.
If I use quadratic equation right here, then what answer?
This is quadratic equation. What are you talking about?
Oh.
Right? Then you factorize, right?
Yeah, it's given.
It's not given, you have to find. So from here you differentiate one time. Can you follow?
So if you want to set down,
quadratic equation.
So now I think I got new method to resolve it. If I use this last time, I cannot do like that, but if now we can use.
Okay, good. So you can, Okay. Now, can everyone turn to example 2? I'm looking for a page. Can you tell me what page is this?
131.
131, Now, can everyone look at this page? Why this page is important is because I need space. There's a space below, right? Can you see the space below? Now, on this space below, can you help me draw a line? Divide this into two. And right here, tell you it's increasing. Then this one right there, show that it's increasing. Can you write that down? Set out the paper. On the bottom, draw a line and then write there two columns. One is tell you it's increasing. The other one is ask you to show that it's increasing. Done? Also never bring. Disgusting. Don't have. Must remember to transfer back to the book. Because I'm using a little book to write. Okay. If you still want to commit. Okay, start. Now, when they tell you it's increasing, this is a typical question. This is an easy question. Can you listen and write at the same time? Okay, start a bit. Start. So when they tell you it's increasing, you can start with dy dx more than 0. Okay? Then after that, you will, like what Jing Da say, usually it's a quadratic more than 0. Then you will have this. Then it's like that. Then you have x more than something or x less than something. Now this is a typical question. In this small book, all the questions are like this. Now on the other side, there's a show question. Okay? Now, show question, can you use another color? And you put down, if start with dy dx more than 0, it's wrong. Again, if you start with dy dx more than 0, straight away the whole question, no need to mark, it's wrong. Because if it shows, you cannot start with this. Alright? So what must you start? You must first start with dy dx is equal to something. Then after that, is equal to something. Then after that, so I give example. Example, dy dx is equals to 3 over x squared. Hey, shit. Sorry, Jing Da. Where is it?
1v1 larger, this is 2
and 1v1. Okay. Yeah. Correct. Okay, continue. Dy dx equals to 3 over x square. Okay, dy dx equals to 3 over x square. And then, the next thing you write is, since x square is more than 0 for all values of x, what do I mean? When x is minus 10, x square is positive. When x is 10, x square is positive. I don't care what x is, it's always positive. Can you think of a value that x square is negative? No. So it's always positive. So it's always positive, therefore dy dx is more than 0. It is increasing. Then you put a show. Is this okay? I repeat. Now, example, dy dx is 3 over x squared. If I look at the 3 over x squared, can this ever be negative? At all, when x is negative, 2 squared, 4. When x is positive, 2, don't care. Positive squared, 2 positive. So I don't care what x is. X squared is always positive. But because x squared is always positive, therefore you say dy dx is always more than 0. And therefore, it is an increasing function. I don't care. Should. Right? So for show question, do you need to find what is x? No, nothing. Okay, common mistake. It will show that it's increasing, you start with what? Dy dx more than 0, yay. Whole thing wrong, no mark. No need to mark already. Can I follow? Alright, I will try and show you one example using the Daniel series question. Not here. Okay. How what?
Nothing.
Okay. Yes, because it's a show question. So when show question cannot, you must start with dy dx equal to something first.
Can I say dy dx less than 0?
All done?